The priority of today's event and this week-long challenge is to make people aware of how important this benefit is to putting food on the table. We are all aware of the planned asset test for food stamps that will take effect May 1st. The new restriction will disqualify thousands of Pennsylvanians, especially seniors and families who are receiving food assistance, just for having savings in the bank. I think we all agree that's not a fair trade. In Washington, Congress has cut more than $14 billion from SNAP, and those cuts that are starting in 2013 will result in a family of four seeing a drop of $60 in their benefits each month.
The first thing is, it seems to me, and Congressman Brady and I were together on another occasion, I used this language, it's mean-spirited to attack children, to attack those who may have lower income, to attack seniors and those who are shut in vulnerable populations. Why in the world would we cut funding for people to eat good food in America? That makes no sense whatsoever. We feed the world. If something bad happens in another part of the world, if there's a tornado, a hurricane, a tsunami, whatever the case may be, as Americans, we always respond to those circumstances and situations, and we literally send the food right out of the back of our Air Force planes with parachutes, and that is the right thing to do.
Live in the United States of America, why do they get off? When if you're just trying to put your food stamps together and try to make a deal, you can't get a break. So we're glad to be here in partnership with all of our friends to send a message that this is the wrong thing to do. We need to figure out a way on May 1st to change that policy. Back them up and get them to say this is not the right way to go. Congressman Brady is right. We need to give Secretary Alexander some food stamps, $35, to see how he can make out for a week's worth of time and a week's worth of shopping. We're glad to be here. We're going to demonstrate to our best abilities that this thing is not working and it's not fair. It's not fair for people by this governor, these folks who are suffering. Again, it's another example of how he's got his foot on the neck of low-income individuals, and we can't tolerate that anymore. Thank you very much.
Kids that go to help kids. All of the time you have politicians running around talking about how they care for kids. Well, in this instance, show us. Show us and stop these foolish policies that limit people's ability to eat. You need food to survive.
I'm going to take this challenge. And I've already talked to my son, who's 19 and 6 feet tall. So can you imagine him trying to take this challenge as well? I'm a mom, and I want to stand for all the mothers who are trying to make good decisions for their families. And for us to hamper that, to make that decision harder, is a disgrace. So I stand with all